Hello friends, welcome to my new video in which I will be discussing 20 Java data types MCQs. I have kept 3 levels in this: easy, medium and hard. I hope you enjoy this video and you take away good amount of knowledge from this video. So let's start. Over here we have our first question: is string a primitive data type in Java? The options we have false and true. So let's see the answer. The answer is false. No, string is not a primitive data type in Java. Okay, so now what exactly is the list of all the primitive data types in Java? So over here we have 8 primitive data types in Java. Okay, char, byte, short, int, long, float, double and boolean. Other than this 8, we do not have any other primitive data type in Java. Whenever you create a variable in Java, according to your requirement, you have to choose one among these. Okay, which among the following is unsigned numeric primitive data type? Okay, so in Java, we have 2 types of data types, you know, one is signed and one is unsigned. Unsigned are those in which you can only save positive value, and signed numeric primitive data types are those in which you can save positive as well as negative. So over here, when we are talking about unsigned numeric primitive data type, the option over here is char. Char is unsigned numeric primitive data type in Java. Long, float and double are signed numeric primitive data types. Fun fact. Okay, there are only 2 Boolean literal values, that is true or false. Whenever we have to create a variable of type Boolean, we can either keep it as true or false. Question number 3. Data type Boolean saves which among the following? Option A, true or false. Option number B, binary values 0 or 1. Option number C, true and false in string, you know, present in double quotes. So the answer over here is A. Whenever we create a data type Boolean, you know, we save it in the form of true or false. Let's move on to the next question. Is Java strongly typed language? True or false? Before, you know, selecting the answer as true or false, let us discuss what exactly is strongly typed languages. Whenever we, you know, assign the data type to a variable, we say that the language is strongly typed. Whenever we write code in JavaScript, we directly write the variable name and assign it the value. We let the compiler decide what data type it has to assign to the variable. We do not apply our brain. Okay, so when it comes to Java, we always write the data type whenever we, you know, define a variable. So I write like, yes, int a equals to 5, boolean b equals to true. So whenever I specify the data type, we say that it is a strongly typed language. So the answer is A, true. Question number 5. Which among these following does not fall under the category of signed integer primitive data type? Double, byte, short, int. So over here, it seems to be a very tricky question, but the word integer over here helps us. So whenever we talk about integers, we know, yes, that int is an integer primitive data type, short is an integer primitive data type, and byte is also an integer primitive data type. So the answer over here is A, double. Double does not fall under the category of signed integer primitive data type. We have a new fun fact. Okay, so I am talking a lot about, you know, signed and signed integers and floating points and everything like that. So I have just written like what are exactly signed integers. So we have 4 signed integers: byte, short, int, long. And when it comes to sine floating point, we have to float and double. Question number 6. Which among them is not true? So over here we have 4 statements and we have to decide which among them is the false one. The size of data type byte is 8 bits. Size of data type short is 16 bits. Size of data type int is 32 bits. And size of data type long is 8 bits. So over here we have yes, byte is 8 bits. So this is true. Short is 16 bits. Again it is true. Int is 32 bits. Again it is true. Long whereas is 64 bits. It is not 8 bits. So the statement number D is false. So the answer over here is D. Size of data type long is 64 bits, not 8 bits. Now let's move on to question number 7. Which among the following is not an integer literal value type? So we have, you know, a numbering system in every programming language, like binary, octal, you know, like 0 to 1 and 0 to 7. It is a way of representing number system. So I have to choose which among the following is not an integer literal value type. I have binary, which is 0 and 1. Then I have octal number system, which is from 0 to 7. Then further, I have decimal number system, which is from 0 to 9. Okay. Then later on, I have hexadecimal number system, which is 16 digits and letters. And then I have Boolean, which is true and false. So over here, the answer is E, Boolean, true and false. Let's move on to the next question, question number 8. For defining an octal literal value, we have to use prefix 0. I have, you know, put MCQ number 8, 9 and 10 for, you know, you to learn prefix. It is basically me stating facts. So the answer over here is true. Whenever you have to define an octal literal, you have to use prefix 0. This is how, you know, compiler decides that the value is, you know, octal or a binary or, you know, hexadecimal. So for defining a binary, question number 9, for defining a binary literal, we have to use prefix 0 and capital B or 0 or small b. So the value is true or false. So the answer is true. Whenever you have to define a binary literal, we have to use prefix 0 capital B or 0 B. Whereas when we talk about octal, we have to use 0. Question number 10. For defining a binary literal, we have to use, I'm sorry, this is not a binary. This is hexa literal. So whenever we define a hexaliteral, we have to use 0x or capital X or 0 with a small x. So the answer is again true. So again, I'm telling you this is for hexadecimal, not binary. I just did control C, control V. So I forgot to change binary to hexadecimal. So let's move on to question number 11. Okay. In Java, float is supposed to be more precise if we compare it with data type double. So over here, whenever we are talking about precision, so which is more precise, float or double? So over here, is, it is not in, it is. Again, I did a mistake. Is Java float supposed to be more precise if we compare it with data type double? So the answer is false. If we compare in terms of precision, double and float, double is the one which is more precise, not float. Question number 12. Which among the following is right way to define a char variable in Java? So whenever we have to define a char variable, do we go with double quotes, single quotes or no quotes? The correct way to define a char variable in Java is using single quotes. So whenever you define a char variable in Java, always put the character in single quotes. Question number 13. Can we do type casting from int to boolean or from boolean to int? Java is something which allows us type casting when we have to, like parse int, parse float. We can use such functions to convert a variable from one data type to another. You just have to be sure both of the data types are compatible of casting. So over here we want to decide if int and boolean are good when it comes to type casting. So the answer is false. We cannot, say 5 as boolean or true as an int. So the both of the types should be compatible to each other when it comes to type casting. Question number 14. Which will not compile? Over here we are given 4 options, and as we can see, only the variable name is changing. So we have student hyphen ID, then we have student ID in camel case, and later we have student underscore ID, and we have student. So among all these 4, option A will not compile, because hyphens are not allowed when we, naming the variables. Let's move on to question number 15. Which among the following is not a keyword in Java? So we have option as null, class, main, abstract. Which among 4 of them is not considered as a keyword in Java? So the answer is C, main. Main is not a keyword in Java. Whenever you think about this question, you may tick null, but no, null is a keyword in Java. Main is not a keyword in Java. Question number 16. What is literal value of all object reference variable? So we have true and false as literal value when it comes to boolean. So what exactly is the literal value of all the object reference variables? So the answer in the question, the options we have is null, zero, nothing, or false. So the answer is A, null. If you do not assign a value to an object reference variable, Java will by default make it point towards null. Question number 17. How many primitive data types Java has? We have discussed it in the first MCQ itself. Java has 8 primitive data types, namely char, byte, short, long, int, float, double, boolean. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Question number 18. Just 2 more questions to go, then we will end the video soon. Which is smallest integer data type? Short, byte, int, double. Do not go with the name short is not the one. The answer is byte. Byte is the smallest integer data type when it comes to Java. Question number 19. What is true in Java? What exactly is true? Name of a class, a keyword, a Boolean literal, or a string? So the answer is C. True is a Boolean literal in Java. Boolean literal has 2 values, namely false and true. Question number 20. Default value of Boolean in Java is true, false, 0, or 1. Many people make a mistake to go with true, but the answer is false. Default value of Boolean in Java is false. Now, we completed the 20 questions. I hope you liked this video. And I'm just, without further ado, let's end this video. Thank you guys for watching.